the Mooers and our school bus.
Mrs. D's here, everybody.
My name is Marty Kushaw, principal of Houlton Junior Senior High School. I'm very pleased to welcome you to the 2009 class of 2009
class of 2009, finally graduating and getting rewarded for what we have been working 13 years for. Remember, never give up. Oh, listen to your mom. She's not working for us. Thank you for joining us on this day of celebration as Houlton High School graduates the 110th senior class. I would like to give a heartfelt thank you to my friends, family, classmates, and teachers for making this night my advice. Continue to look at life with the same attitude that has been our trademark for the past 13 years. Our class has always sought to venture beyond the boundaries. We've explored the unconventional and have never been afraid to think outside the box. Think different may be the motto for at the computer, but I think that it's also a very fitting motto for the class of 2009. It is my pleasure to introduce to you the class of 2009's commencement speaker, Mr. Timothy Tweedy.
Was it the celebrity factor? Do I have what the kids call it? Something that made the class want to be able to tell their college friends, guess who spoke at my graduation? Again, a resounding no. For up until this point in my life, I cannot pinpoint a single moment or achievement that would put me anywhere near the status of a Senator Smith or a Governor King. Finally, I concluded, it must be my good looks. The students must have wanted someone handsome and elegant, a pretty face permanently enshrined into all their memories, a fixture of their graduation. Then I remembered that merely 2 years ago, the class of 2007 asked my good friend Paul Prosser to be their keynote speaker. Obviously, I know at that moment had nothing to do with their lives. Unable to pinpoint a single reason for this distinction, I concluded that it may not be the best idea to focus on me, but rather on you, the graduates, as well as you, the audience. For certainly by now, this senior class has come to realize how their accomplishments have come to be. Yes, graduates, you've been the ones who had to wake up 2,275 mornings in the last 13 years to come to school. Yes, you've had to be the ones to read the books, do the homework, and take the exams. Yes, you've endured the women in history pageants, the science fairs, and the research papers. But understand, you have not done this alone. Over the last 2 years, I've discovered here in this town of Houlton an unparalleled support structure and an unequivocal amount of generosity. This community is second to none when it comes to supporting its young people, and you are all proof of the benefits of a caring society. It is important to realize that you are entering the world of adulthood in a far different one than I graduated into just 11 years ago. 34% of all Americans are currently living below the poverty line. We recently endured 28 consecutive months of job loss, the longest in our nation's history. The average price of a home in Detroit, Michigan, the backbone of our nation's manufacturing industry, is only $7,500. And even the Ricker Scholarship, a once thought to be immovable staple of our local graduation season, is unavailable this year due to the severity of the present-day economy. And while the rest of the country has become unnerved, trying to figure out when the fortunes will change for the better, we here in Aroostook County have not acted as though the sky is falling. Why is that? Maybe when you've only ever known one side of a bubble, it's difficult to determine just how bad things actually are. Or maybe it's because long ago we accepted the fact that our prosperity up here will never reach the level of a Manhattan, New York, or even a Cape Elizabeth, Maine. But students, when you asked for a skate park, it was built. When our high school auditorium was deemed unfit for such a prosperous program, this town voted overwhelmingly to construct you a new one. You've been garnished with new Little League fields. You've hosted world-renowned entertainers in this arena, which doubles as an ice hockey rink. Your town's worked hard to provide you with the best soapbox derby go around, a beautiful downtown amphitheater, the Millennium Walking Bridge, an insanely successful recreation department, and the list goes on and on and on, and I commend you on that. Such benevolence brings to mind an old Buddhist fable that I recently read. It begins, a Buddhist monk was walking barefoot down a dusty road when he stepped on something sharp. It stuck in his heel, so after a few steps, he stopped to pull it out. Lo and behold, it was a very beautifully carved gemstone. The monk rinsed it off in a well he was passing and hid the gem inside of a loaf of bread he had in his satchel. The loaf was to be his only meal of the day. A little further down the road, the monk came upon a beggar. The beggar spied the partial loaf, leapt in front of the monk, bowed three times, and said, "O venerable sir, I am but a poor, starving beggar. Might I have a taste of your bread?" So the monk pulled the loaf from his satchel, but before handing it to the beggar, he pulled the gem from the crust where it had been hidden. As the monk was handing the loaf to the beggar, the gemstone became visible. The beggar pleaded, "O most worthy one, I have taken your only meal of the day, and that is not right. I see you have a gemstone which would relieve me of my situation. May I give you back your bread in exchange for the gem?" At this, the monk promptly gave the gemstone to the beggar, telling him also to keep the bread. And the beggar was ecstatic and galloped off down the road. The monk, noticing it was time for mediation, sat down under a nearby tree. A few minutes later, he became aware of the presence of someone. Opening his eyes, he saw the beggar, who thrust out his hand again, saying, "O venerable one, may I please return this gem to you, for I don't want it now." The monk, beginning to grow impatient with the beggar, said, "Sir, what is it that you can want?" And the beggar replied, "I now want what it is that allowed you to give away everything." Houlton, you are that Buddhist monk. You are the ones who are willing to give away your gemstone as long as it ensures that your children the best life an Aroostook County dollar can provide. And do you know what amazes me? I don't think you even realize how truly unique you are. Thank you.
What truly, honestly, was challenging about high school was that we were learning to deal with reality. Some of us were burdened financially. Some of our parents divorced. Some of us had our hearts broken, and some of us broke others' hearts. Some of us got speeding tickets. Some of us ran Chinese restaurants. Some of us built Chinese restaurants. Some of us found faith, and some of us lost faith. We all went through something difficult besides the norms of high school.
Thank you. Yours forever.
Now we say goodbye.
I'm teaching him a lesson here.
No, he's not.